Good morning. This is Jill over at Live Your Talk. I hope you're having a great day so far. Have you ever thought about video blogging? Are you new to video blogging? If so, I hope you dive in. And I've just been motivated by a friend and colleague who has started her first video today. And it's actually over at Lisa Byrne, Lisa, LisaByrne.me, if you want to take a look. She is really diving into a big goal in terms of becoming more confident, comfortable on video, and then also becoming confident, comfortable as a public speaker overall. So I think all of that is exciting and better than a box of chocolates. But this is why I think specifically she succeeded in her video, and not to impersonalize a video blog. It's personal, it's fun, it doesn't have to be this grand arching thing called, quote, success. But I couldn't stop looking at her. It was about a 4-minute clip, and really reviewing more what happened with her video cut. This is why I think it was just not only fun and engaging, but successful. Three things. It was honest, it had assertion, and it created momentum in different types of topics, but in a simple way. So first of all, you know what? She didn't hold back. She's close to the camera, looking directly at the lens, and she gave honesty. The camera finds truth. It's a truth seeker. She was honest in saying, hey, I'm nervous. This is it. Here are my facial tics. Here's what I'm talking about. Then secondly, overall, in this 4 minutes, she didn't have a clear-cut message as if it was a media interview, but that's not a deficit. She had clear intent. Talking about this assertion piece, she asserted intent as in, hey, this is what I'm doing for my February fantasies. That was the name of her first video blog. And she listed, hey, I'm working on my health. I am cutting back on the wine and I'm diving into public speech training and video blogging. Here I am. She was not holding back and giving the audience or the video lens, this eye, everything she had, in terms of unconditional truth. It really came across that way. Thirdly, she had momentum. Toward the end, she expressed concern about, wow, I hope these things have more structure in the future. At the same time, her cut wasn't completely structureless. In fact, I think it had its own structure because it offered a consecutive type sequence. She said, hey, she was looking at a blackboard behind her, and she said, hey, here's what I'm doing this month to really become more effective. Bap, 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 bap. Excuse me. It was natural. It worked. It reflected her intent of the video. I really enjoyed it. So when diving into your own video blog or even practicing video work, here are three questions to potentially help you get started. One, what can you be honest about? The camera is a truth seeker. It can detect distraction. It can detect insincerity. So that's a good place to start. Second question, how can you assert a point of view? How can you assert clear intent for 2 or 3 minutes on camera? And thirdly, how can you add momentum by talking about a few different angles, a few different points of view, a few different ideas related to an overarching topic to break up sequence and flow and topic matter within your 2 or 3 minute video cut. This is Jill over at Live Your Talk. I hope you have a great day.